हेलो फ्रेंड्स, टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू हैव ब्रेनस्टॉर्मिंग सेशन ऑन अ वेरी इम्पोर्टेंट टॉपिक, व्हाई बिहेवियर बेस्ड सेफ्टी फेल्स इन ऑर्गेनाइजेशन। मेनी ऑर्गेनाइजेशन वेरी एंथुजियास्टिकली एग्जीक्यूटिंग बिहेवियर बेस्ड सेफ्टी प्रोग्राम, बट स्टिल दे आर नॉट गेटिंग डिजायर्ड सेफ्टी रिजल्ट इन टर्म्स ऑफ नंबर ऑफ एक्सीडेंट एंड ट्रांसफॉर्मेशन ऑफ सेफ्टी कल्चर। In this session, we will discuss where is gap, what is main lever which we need to pull to get our behavior-based safety program in right direction. By end of this session, you will learn what are misleading elements which prohibit behavior-based safety program to execute in right direction. What are mistakes leadership always make in terms of thinking and decision making. Next, we will discuss partially on element of behavior based safety. Then we will discuss on root cause, why behavior based safety fails in organization. Then we will discuss on second root cause, how decision making influences behavior. We will discuss some case study related to it with the to understand it in a better way. After it, we will discuss about worker behavior versus organizational behavior. We will discuss what are main lever of behavior-based safety. And finally, we will conclude session. So friends, all of you know that 80-90% accident caused by unsafe act or at-risk behavior. So now question is it correct? Yes, it is correct, but same time it is misleading. A statement set up a safety leader to think if we just fix this employee, then we will able to eliminate risk. A statement encourage safety leader to put all blame on their associate and leader prevent their responsibility and off hook being responsible for creating safe workplace. Here I would like to add one more misleading statement that 90% of unsafe condition created by unsafe act. It means worker is responsible for creating almost 80-98% of accident. Now, question to all of you, why worker do that much of unsafe act and what are root cause which trigger worker to do this kind of act? Incident caused by many of factor in which at-risk behavior is one. So most of leader, when they talk about behavior, they think of frontline employee behavior, and it's a human nature. The person that got hurt did something that caused accident. So if you want to prove it, look at 10-year accident report in your organization and you will find that conclusion. Will say something like this: instruct employee to follow safe procedure and cause of accident. You will find out like this: employee failure to follow procedure. So above statement don't tell you whole story. Intact of their omission tell a misleading story. Now you can understand that where our behavior-based safety approach is going. Let's understand quickly element of behavior-based safety to understand where is gap. So behavior-based safety based on four key steps. First, we identify critical behavior. Second, we gather data for observation. Third, have conversation with worker and give feedback. And last,
accumulate data to identify, prioritize, and solve problem. And this is traditional way of to execute a behavior-based safety program in organization. If you look at the way organization executing a behavior-based safety program, to keeping required documents, picture, graph, presentation, you will appraise people who are doing it. But when come to safety result in terms of accident statistics, visual safety culture, you will keep thinking why behavior-based safety fails in organization to prevent accident and transform safety culture. So, out of four element of behavior-based safety, up to third step, behavior-based safety program executed very enthusiastically, but fourth step, use accumulated data to identify, prioritize, and solve problem is not actually practiced in organization. Organization failed to identify, analyze, solve root cause of at-risk behavior. If you want to cultivate safety culture, you need to identify and fix its driver. While analysis of accumulated data, leader need to have some question in their mind. If worker are not following procedure, why not? Is behavior within their control? Does culture support doing it safely, or does no one follow the procedure? Last one is, what we need to do to set safe behavior? So this kind of question always leader need to have in their mind while analysis. So suppose, let's have example. Suppose you work on your repair and maintenance area where one of your maintenance technician using grinder and he's not wearing safety goggles. Can you think some reason why technician might not wear required PP? So let's have discussion on answer. Perhaps PP is not comfortable. Second reason, maybe person does not see the value in wearing it because supervisor and other people in area do not wear. Then perhaps employee has skipped wearing PP. Whatever the reason, leader need to identify and fix root cause of particular at-risk behavior. So, let's discuss on second root cause, why behavior-based safety fail in organization. So, second root cause is decision-making influences behavior. Let's understand with the one case study. In metal recycling plant, dust explosion killed 3 employees in year 2010. On day of explosion, a maintenance technician installed a bed blade in blending machine and returned it to service. As soon as machine started, flash fire developed inside and machine exploded. Machine explosion ignited dust which had accumulated inside of building and caused a second catastrophic explosion. So, what maintenance technician did is only end point of a story. This is not actual cause of explosion. Knowing the result without knowing cause that led to it reveal almost no useful information what we need to done to prevent this kind of event happening again. When thing going wrong, it's natural to ask question, who is responsible? Failure to see real root cause lead to short-sighted solution that's often make situation worse. So let's know what Blade striking the sidewall were known to be an issue for a year. Blade were wearing out with increasing frequency, and each time technician replaced them. Technician had found more evidence that they had a scraping inside a blender. Technician had put out several small fire inside the blender, fire that were caused by a spark from the blade scraping the sidewall. This was well-known issue. Technician were not acting alone. Manager, supervisor, and other seniors had been consulting n number of times, and number of solution had been tried. Management made decision to continue without having found a solution, knowing it was leaving unsafe workplace intact. At least once, when maintenance department did not have new blade in inventory, a decision was made to adjust old blade so that blade would not strike sidewall. While repairing, maintenance technician found large crack in sidewall of the machine, probably caused by a stress of blade striking it. So after that, decision was made to weld a crack and return to machine to operation. On day of explosion, technician was doing exactly what he had learned to do over all these years. Keep blender going, old part if necessary, feel free to deviate procedure. Nobody questioned him. In fact, for casual arrangement, maintenance technician would be regarded as a hero. So, I hope you understand how wrong decision making influence at-risk behavior and ultimately incident. So now let's discuss about organizational behavior and worker behavior. If you want to success behavior-based safety in your organization, you need to capture information about driver of behavior, organizational behavior in terms of safe decision making, organizational system, culture, and leadership. So, in case of metal recycling plant, if any other person in place of maintenance placed in facility would have done the same thing as maintenance technician done just before explosion. It means it is not an individual worker behavior issue, but issue of organizational behavior. So, if you do right thing, you will pull right lever, you will see safe behavior and better safety result in your organization. So, now question is, what is this lever? Of course, leadership is a strong lever. Nobody is in better position to influence organization performance than senior management. Senior leader decision drive culture and system, which in turn drive organizational behavior and performance. So, for example, in metal recycling plant, the senior leadership team could decide to start looking at maintenance log and inventory of blade and free up money to address safety issue. Doing this changes basic assumption about what expected of worker and supervisor about importance of safety. So, come to conclusion of this session. A shallow focus on behavior bring attention to endpoint, but it does not tell you how to improve it. If you want to improve behavior, you need to change what driving it and to understand that we need to able to see the decision that caused it. So, hope you have enjoyed session. If you have not yet subscribed this, please subscribe. Thank you and have a safe day.